Subscribe to my channel and do not forget to press the bell icon. It's totally free. Welcome everybody. Welcome to my channel Juris Central Online Classes for Law Exams. Today we will be discussing the highly demanded SALT paper of CLAT LLM Entrance Test 2019 with SALT essay. This is the first time on YouTube in which the session of SALT paper of CLAT PG is being played on Premiere. Kindly let me know your queries, suggestions, feedback if any in the chat box. I shall surely reply you. Kindly wave at us by typing hi or hello in the chat box. First of all, thanks to everyone who has watched our channel more than 33,000 times and to our subscribers for subscribing our channel. Juris Central has till now completed 6 years of solved questions of DU LLM entrance exam. This is the latest session in which we would discuss previous year solved papers of CLAT PG exam. You can go to the playlist section of the channel to watch the missed videos. Kindly listen to this class carefully. In case you are facing any doubt, comment your queries in the chat box. Do not worry, I am there to help you. We will soon bring a live session for you in which you can have direct interaction with me. So let us start this session with our first question. You can also share your answer in the chat box. So let's start. This is part A and the maximum marks is 100 and the total number of questions also 100. This is the objective part and part B is the subjective. Question number 1. The minimum number of judges of the Supreme Court who are to sit to decide any case involving a substantial question of law as to the interpretation of the Constitution shall be. Correct option is option number B, 5. Which of the following duties was inserted by way of an amendment in 2002? This is question number 2. The correct option is option number D, who is a parent or guardian to provide opportunities for education to his child or as a case may be ward between the age of 6 and 14 years. Third, the Parliament of India consists of, the correct option is option number B, President and two Houses of Parliament. Fourth, the Goods and Services Tax Council shall make recommendations to the Union and the states on a number of issues. Special provisions as to how many states the council can make recommendations. The correct option is option number C, 11. Fifth, how many high courts are there in India? This is a cancel question because the correct option is option number 25. 25th high court is situated in the state of Andhra Pradesh. Sixth, what is the total strength of the Supreme Court including the Chief Justice of India? So according to the year 2019, like when the exam was conducted, the correct answer was option number C, 31. But the current answer is 34. So the number of judges has been increased from 31 to 34 by the Supreme Court Number of Judges Amendment Bill 2019. 7. The Chief Justice of India who passed away while in office was, so option number B, Justice Sabyasachi Mukherjee. 8. Every promise and every set of promises forming the consideration for each other is known as, option number B, agreement, and this is given under section 2 clause E of Indian Contract Act. 9. The correct sequence in the formation of a contract is this, option number D. First, there shall be offer, then acceptance, after that consideration, and finally agreement takes place. 10th, match list 1 with list 2 and select the correct answer using the codes given below the list. The correct option is option number A, Muhiri Baby case is related to minors contract. Satyabrata Ghosh case is related to frustration of contract. Hadley versus Baxendale is related to remoteness of damage, and Carlin versus Carbolic, this case is related to invitation to treat. 11. Acceptance sent through post. So the correct option is option number C, can be revoked before it comes to the knowledge of the offerer. 12. CEDAW was adopted by the UN General Assembly in the year. So it was adopted in the year of 1979. The correct option is option number A. 13. Human rights treaty bodies. So what actually they do? So correct option is option number C. They monitor human rights treaties. 14. The following committee cannot hear individual complaints of human rights violations. So correct option is option number B, committee that monitors human rights bodies. 15. Section dash of the Copyright Act grants an author special rights which exist independently of the author's copyright and subsist even after the assignment, whole or partial of the said copyright. The correct option is option number C, 57, which deals with author's special right. 16. The amendment to the Patents Act stated that computer program per se is not an invention, raising a debate whether as computer program with any additional features such as tactical features would be patentable. So the correct option is option number D, 2002. So what they're actually asking, like the amendment year of the Patents Act in which so and so has been added. So the correct option is option number D, 2002. 17. If any dispute arises regarding publication of work, dash will be the final authority to decide the same. The correct option is option number A, Copyright Board. 18. What are the types of inventions which are not patentable in India? The correct option is all of these. What can be patented in India is given under section 3 and 4. 19th. For HLA Hart, the open texture of law means that the regulation of areas of conduct must be left to be developed by. So it must be left to be developed by courts, option number B. 20. According to Immanuel Kant, rational formal knowledge is. This is option number C, concerned with the form of understanding and reasons themselves. 21. Austinian notion of positive morality is. So it is actually a socially constructed, option number B. 22. For Roscoe Pound, dual postulates are to be discovered. So it has to be discovered in the law itself, option number A. 23rd. According to John Austin, the relationship between the sovereign and political independent society is, option number C, elliptical. 24. John Rawls' concept of justice is a, it's a political concept, option number B. 25th. According to realists, the correct option is option number B, precedent is real law. 26th. What are states without justice but Robert Barnes enlarged? Asked. So it has been asked by option number B, St. Augustine. 27th. The following thinker is normally associated with the secularization of natural law. Option number A, Hugo Grotius. 28th. The President of India can be removed from office by. So the correct option is option number C, resolution passed by the Council of States and agreed to by the House of the People. 29th. The President decides on disqualification of members of Parliament under Article 103 only on the advice of. The correct option is option number C, Election Commission, under Article 324. Election Commission has been provided. 30. The recent amendment to the Constitution of India paving way for 10% reservation for economically weaker sections was done by amending. So it was done by amending Articles 15 and 16, option number B. 31. How many amendments have been made to the Indian Constitution so far? The correct option is option number C, according to the year 2019, but the current amendments are 104. So what is the 104th amendment? So it extended the reservation of seats for SCs and STs in the Lok Sabha and states assemblies. 32. The National Commission for Backward Classes was created by. So it was created by option number B, the Constitution 102nd Amendment Act 2018. 33. Which of the following states has no legislative council? Option number D, Madhya Pradesh. 34. Passive euthanasia under circumstance is permissible was upheld in the case of. So it was upheld in the case of Aruna Ramachandra Schonberg versus Union of India, option number A. 35. The maxim optio personalis, monitor cum persona, means. So it means option number A, personal action dies with the parties to the cause of action. 36. Mark the incorrect entries. So which one of the following is incorrect? This option number C, remoteness of damage, Ryles versus Fletcher. Everybody knows that the principle of strict liability has been involved in the case of Ryles versus Fletcher. 37. In Ryles versus Fletcher, Justice Blackburn used the term, like we have already seen the answer of the question in the previous slide. So this option number A, strict liability. 38. Contributory negligence is a, it's actually a defense, option number C. 39. Voluntary non-fit injuria is a, it is actually a defense, but the answer is given wrong in the answer key, which says option number C, that it's not a defense, but in reality it's actually a defense in tort law. 40. Test of directness for determining remoteness of damage was laid down in, this is Re-Polemis, option number C, Re-Polemis case. 41. Following is not an essential of tort of negligence. So what is not essential in tort of negligence is option number A, duty of care on the part of plaintiff. 42. Defamation is, so defamation is both a tort and crime, option number A. 43. A person abates the doing of a thing by, he abates the doing of a thing by doing all of the above, and this is given in section 108 of IPC, which deals with abettor. So what all things it consists of? So first, instigating any person. Second, engages in any conspiracy. And third, intentionally aiding. 44. When two or more persons agree to do an illegal act, such an act is known as. So such an act is known as criminal conspiracy. And this is given under section 120A of IPC, which deals with the definition of criminal conspiracy. 45. To commit an affray, the minimum number of persons required is. So minimum number of persons required is 2. This is given under section 159 of IPC, which deals with affray, the definition of affray. 46. Outraging the modesty of a woman is punishable under. So it is punishable under section 354 of IPC. Again in answer key, the option was wrong. So it was given there section 509, but I have already discussed here that what 509 actually deals with. So it deals with word, gesture or act intended to insult the modesty of a woman. 363 deals with punishment for kidnapping, and 511 deals with punishment for attempting to commit offences punishable with imprisonment for life or other imprisonment. 47. Opinion juris means. So it means option number B, opinion of law. 48. Jus cogens means. It means non-derogable norms. In other words, it's also known as preemptory norms. 49. Jus gentium is a body of. So jus gentium is a body of international customs, option number D. 50. World Intellectual Property Organization is a specialized agency of. So it's a specialized agency of option number A, UN. There are currently 70 specialized agencies and WIPO is one of them. The Rome Statute of the International Court was adopted in the year. So it was adopted in the year option number A in 1998. Which one of the following is not formally considered as an amendment to the Constitution under Article 368? The correct option is option number B, change in the preamble. 53. Who presides over the joint sitting of the two Houses of Parliament? This is option number A, the Speaker. 54. Which of the following category of judges is not mentioned in the constitution? Now, this is option number D, pew sign judges, and all the three judges has been mentioned in the constitution of India. 55. The right to vote in elections in India is a, so it is actually a constitutional right. This is given under Article 326, which deals with election as to the House of the People and to the legislative assemblies of states to be on the basis of adult suffrage. 56. The fundamental right to form cooperative societies is provided under, so it is provided under Article 19 clause 1 clause C, which is option number A. Article 19 deals with protection of certain rights regarding freedom of speech, etc. 57. The ordinance making power of the president under the Indian constitution is, it is an executive power and it is prescribed under Article 123. 123 deals with promulgation of ordinance by president. 58. The concurrent power to impose tax has been provided under this option number D, Article 246A. So 246A deals with special provision with respect to goods and services tax, and this has been added by 101st Amendment in the Constitution of India. 59. The Goods and Services Tax Council is set up under, so it is set up under option number C, Article 279A. 60. Who was the constitutional advisor to the Constituent Assembly? This option number A, B.N. Rao. 61. Which one of the following is the correct statement in relation to the collegium? This is option number A, appointment and transfer of judges in the higher judiciary. 62. Compulsory jurisprudence was invoked by the Supreme Court in, this is option number B, Rudra Shah versus State of Bihar. 63. Basheshwar Nath versus Commissioner of Income Tax is often quoted with reference to the, so it is often quoted with reference to the option number C, Doctrine of Waiver of Fundamental Rights. 64. Ganupati versus Nafizul Hasan deals with, so it deals with privileges of the legislature. 65. Reservation and promotions with consequential seniority in favor of scheduled castes and scheduled tribes is facilitated by, so it is facilitated by option number A, Article 16 clause 4A. 66. Article 141 of the Indian Constitution provides, so it provides option number B, law declared by the Supreme Court shall be binding on all courts within the territory of India. 67. Doctrine of legitimate expectation and Wednesday principles were read by Supreme Court into option number B, Article 14. 68. A 7-member bench of the Supreme Court unanimously struck down clauses 2 clause T of Article 323A and clause 3 clause T of Article 323B of the Constitution relating to tribunals, which excluded the jurisdiction of High Court and Supreme Court. The court held that power of judicial review over legislative action is vested in the High Court under Article 226 and in the Supreme Court under Article 32. This is an integral part of the basic structure of the Constitution. Name the case. Very easy question. The answer is option number A, L. Chandra Kumar versus Union of India. 69. The phrase complete justice is used in, so it is used in option number B, Article 142. It deals with enforcement of decrees and orders of Supreme Court and unless as to this discovery, etc. Article 141 deals with law declared by Supreme Court to be binding on all courts. This option has been framed into the question which we have just now dealt in the previous slide. Article 144, civil and judicial authorities to act in aid of the Supreme Court. Article 145, it deals with rules of court, etc. 70. In which case the doctrine of severability was extended by the Supreme Court to constitutional amendments? This is option number D, Kyoto Holohan versus Jakilu. 71. Among the following judges against whom the motion for removal were initiated in either House of Parliament, This is option number B, Justice Ramaswamy and Justice Soumitra Sen. 72. Recently the Supreme Court in Ram Janmabhoomi case, it option number A, has ordered mediation by a panel. 73. The Constitution Day is celebrated on, so it is celebrated on option number C, 26th of November. 74. If the Anglo-Indian community is adequately represented, the president may nominate not more than dash members to the Lok Sabha. The correct option is option number B, 2. See, by the 126th Constitutional Amendment Bill 2009, which has been passed by the Parliament and which extended the reservation provided for SCs and STs communities in Parliament and assemblies, but it also provided stopping the nomination of Anglo-Indians to Lok Sabha and certain state assemblies. 75. In which case the Supreme Court applied the doctrine of prospective overruling for the first time to resolve a constitutional question? This is option number D, Golaknath versus State of Punjab. 76. How many judges of the Supreme Court were superseded in the appointment of Justice A.N. Ray as the Chief Justice of India? This is option number B, 3. So this appointment actually superseded 3 senior judges of the Supreme Court, who are Jay Shankar, Manilal Shelat, A.N. Grover and K.S. Hegde. So this is actually considered a very controversial appointment in the Supreme Court. 77. The directive principles of state policy were framed based on the provisions of, this is option number C, Irish Constitution. 78. A applied for allotment of 100 shares in B company. A letter of allotment addressed to A was posted in due course, but it never reached A. The posting of letter of allotment. So in this case, the posting of letter of allotment doesn't complete the contract. This option number B. 79. A takes a life insurance policy, making a false statement about his health and doesn't disclose the fact that he has been treated for a serious illness. In this case, which one of the following statement is correct? So the correct option is option number C. The contract is voidable on the ground of fraud and this is given under section 19 of Contract Act. 80. In which case it has been laid down that a promise to pay subscription is binding on the promissory. Promisee has undertaken some liability on the faith of the promisee. This is option number B, Kedarnath versus Ghori Mohammed. 81. Is past consideration for a promise valid to create a contract? This is option number A. It is valid only in Indian law and not in English law. 82. An agreement not enforceable by law is? So it is actually a void agreement and this is given under section 2 clause G of Indian Contract Act. 83. Where the relations subsisting between the parties are such that one of the parties is in a position to dominate the will of the other and uses that position to obtain an unfair advantage over the other is known as. It is known as D, option number D, undue influence, and this is given under section 16 of Indian Contract Act. 84. Defaming someone by words or by gesture is called in torts acts. So it is called slander, option number B. 85. What defense could be used when an injury is caused to a person due to unforeseen or unexpected events in spite of reasonable care taken by him? This is option number A, inevitable accident. 86. Under section 57 of the Indian Penal Code, in calculating fractions of terms of punishment, imprisonment for life shall be reckoned as equivalent to imprisonment for, this is option number A, 20 years. 87. A soldier fired on a mob by the order of his superior officer in conformity with the commands of the law. Choose the correct statement. Correct statement is option number C. A has committed no offence and this is given under section 76 of Indian Penal Code, which deals with act done by a person bound or by mistake of fact believing himself bound by law. 88. The principle that nothing is an offence which is done by a child under 7 years of age is provided under. It is provided under option number B, section 82 of IPC. Let's see about the other section. Section 81 deals with or it provides. Act likely to cause harm but done without criminal intent and to prevent other harm. 83 deals with act of a child above 7 and 12 years of immature understanding. 84 deals with act of a person of unsound mind. 89. Every person has a right to defend dash against any offense. The correct option is option number C. His own body and the body of any other person. And this is given under section 97. 90. Acts under the influence of madness, attempts to kill wife. This given in option number C. The correct option is option number C, that Y has right of private defense, which he would have if X were sane. 91. The right of private defense of property against theft continues till. So it continues till all of the above, option number D. This is given under section 105 of Indian Penal Code, which deals with commencement and continuance of the right of private defense of property. So, in case the offender has effected his retreat with the property, the assistance of the public authorities is obtained and the property has been recovered. In all these cases, the right of private defense of property against theft continues. 92. The Universal Declaration of Human Rights was adopted on. So, it was adopted on December 10th, 1948. This is option number C. 93. The United Nations Commission on Human Rights meets every year at. So it meets at Geneva. Option number B. 94. What is the term of a patent in the Indian system? This option number A. 20 years. 95. What are the classes of works for which copyright protection is available in India? The correct option is in all of the above cases, the copyright protection is available in India, like original, literary, dramatic, musical and artistic works, cinematograph, films and sound recordings. 96. In the case of a work made or first published by or under the direction or control of any public undertaking dash shall, in the absence of any agreement to the contrary, be the first owner of the copyright therein. So the correct option is option number B, such public undertaking, and this is provided under section 17 of the Copyright Act, which deals with first owner of copyright. 97. If the period of assignment copyright is not stated, it shall be deemed to be dash years from the date of assignment. So it has to be reckoned from the period of 5 years, and this is given under section 19, which deals with mode of assignment, and in this case the correct option is option number B. 98. Which of the following statement is right? This is option number B. An invention must possess utility for the grant of patent. No valid patent can be granted for an invention devoid of utility. 99. How many GI tags have been issued in India so far? So the present, I would tell you the answer, what is the current situation. So currently 361 GI tags have been issued, but in the year of 2019 the correct answer was about 344. Recently Kashmir saffron and black rice Manipur got this GI tag. Kindly remember this fact. 100. The courts are the capitals of laws empire and judges are its princes. So who wrote this? So this is written by Ronald Dworkin, option number B. So this is part B. Here the maximum marks is 50. So let me tell you the instructions how to solve the subjective part of the question, like what are their instructions. So according to the question paper, you have to answer any two of the following questions. All questions carry equal mark, that means 25 each. And answer to each question shall not exceed 800 words. This is very much important. You shall always write your answer within the word limits. Do not exceed the word limits. So let me tell you that how you should write subjective questions and essay. So see, first you should start with a short introduction. No need to write lengthy introduction. You can write a short introduction. Second, definition if any. So it totally depends on question types. If the question warrants you to define in any term, so you are free to define. Otherwise, this is not very much necessary. Third, body. Body is the most essential part of the essay. In this part, you shall always mention case laws and provisions in law, like sections or article. This is very much important. You shall always mention any case laws. Case laws play more weightage to your answer, especially in questions where mentioning of case laws is required, like I have already told you just now. Mentioning of provisions are must. Yes, this is very much important. You shall mention about like the sections, articles. It is very much important that you always mention these two things. First one is case law and the second one is provision. See, the number of mentioning case laws is not fixed. It depends on question types, but try to mention at least two case laws. This is very much important, like because you are solving answer which is belonging to the field of law. So this is very much important that you mention at least two case laws. I mean nobody can say that how many case laws you should write. It totally depends on the question type, but try to mention at least two. Like the more you mention the number of case laws, the more you score. Yeah, this is a very a blunt fact. Fourth, conclude your answer with a short conclusion. You shall always do it. Like if, suppose in many cases people skip to write the introduction, that's okay. But you shall always conclude your answer with the conclusion, incorporating your own views and ideas. And there are other things that you shall keep in your mind while solving subjective questions, while answering subjective questions. Like try to write within the word limits, keep your answer to the point. Yeah, this is very much important because you have to write within the word, so you have to answer to the point. Avoid randomly filling the answer sheet like many people do. When they do not get any answer, they randomly just start filling the answer sheet. You shall avoid doing that. Keep yourself updated with the latest judicial decisions. Yeah, of course. Being a law student or being LLM aspirant, you shall always keep it in mind that you keep yourself updated with any latest judgment, any judicial decision. This is very much important. And you shall inculcate the habit of reading newspaper every day for at least 1 hour. Yeah, because questions are framed not only from the field of not only from judicial decision, but it can also be framed from anything which has been the headline, which has been an of national importance. So this is our first essay question. Let me tell you one thing clearly. Do not copy the answers. The answers are suggestive in nature. Try to write it in your own words. I have taken the source of this answer from Bayer Acts and judicial decisions. So let us see the question. The Supreme Court observed that the ordinance making power has been used to such an extent that its use has become fraud on the Constitution. Critically examine the statement in the light of the constitutional provisions, practices, conventions and judicial decisions. So I have started it with an introduction. The question is based on the judicial decision of the Supreme Court, namely Krishna Kumar Singh versus State of Bihar. Let me read it to you. So it's a 7-judge constitution bench of the Honorable Supreme Court of India, which has held that repromulgation of ordinance is a fraud on the Constitution. The court also held that satisfaction of the President of India under Article 123 and of the Governor under Article 213 while issuing an ordinance is not immune from judicial review. Definition. What is an ordinance? So, you shall also write a short definition. In this question, I have written what is an ordinance, the definition of an ordinance. So, Article 123 of the Constitution of India gives the power and authority to the President of India to issue an ordinance only when both the Houses of Parliament are not in session. Article 213 mandates near identical terms with respect to the ordinances on subject of state authority. Article 123, and later on you shall write a brief about Article 123 and Article 213. According to Article 123, the President can promulgate ordinances during the recess of Parliament if at any time except when both Houses of Parliament are in session, the President is satisfied that circumstances exist which render it necessary for him to take immediate action, he may promulgate such ordinance as the circumstances appear to him to require. Article 213. This article empowers the governor. It is actually in same words as is used in Article 123. This article empowers the governor to promulgate ordinance during recess of legislature if circumstances exist which render it necessary for him to take immediate action. To issue an ordinance, the governor must be satisfied with the circumstances that make it necessary for him to take immediate action. Governor cannot promulgate an ordinance if the two exceptions are given. When the ordinance has a provision of which the governor would reserve as a bill containing them for the president's sanction, if an act of the state legislature has the same provisions, that would be invalid without the assent of the president. So what the judgment says? So Dr. D.Y. Chandrachud, justice, writing down the majority judgment for himself and S.A. Bogde, A.K. Goel, U.U. Lalit and L. Nageshwara Rao, justice, laid down the principles for promulgation of ordinances as follows. First, the power which has been conferred upon the president under Article 123 and the governor under Article 213 is legislative and conditional in nature. Second, an ordinance which is promulgated under Article 123 or Article 213 has the same force and effect as a law enacted by the legislature, but it must be laid before the legislature and it will cease to operate 6 weeks after the legislature has reassembled or even earlier if a resolution disapproving it is passed. Next one, the requirement of laying an ordinance before Parliament or the state legislature is a mandatory constitutional obligation cast upon the government. So it is made mandatory that ordinance has to be laid before the state legislature or Parliament as the case may be, and to the satisfaction of the President under Article 123 and of the Governor under Article 213 is not immune from judicial review. Next, repromulgation of ordinances is a fraud on the Constitution and a subversion of democratic legislative processes as laid down in the judgment of the Constitution Bench in D.C. Wadhwa and others versus State of Bihar and others. So in this judgment, another judgment was also quoted, and in that judgment also the same view has been held. So let's say about the minority judgment. So Madan B. Locute dissented from the majority view and wrote down his own minority view that there is no universal or blanket prohibition against repromulgation of an ordinance, but it should not be a mechanical repromulgation and should be a very rare occurrence. So here comes the conclusion. This judgment widens the scope of judicial review ordinances. It basically promotes more transparency in the functioning of the same, and the court can exercise the powers of judicial review and verify the actions undertaken by both the president and the governor so as to arrive at the satisfaction that an ordinance was necessary or not. But in recent times, ordinance making power has been widely misused as a parallel law making body of the government. Therefore, in light of the above arguments, it can be rightly said that ordinance making power has been used to such an extent that its use has become a fraud on the Constitution. Next question, briefly explain and critically evaluate the concept of victims' compensation in India in the light of statutory provisions and judicial decisions. In the question also I have started it with a short introduction. The victim protection jurisprudence developed in United Nations General Assembly 1985 by adopting a declaration of the basic principles of justice for the victims of crime and abuse of power, which was ratified by a substantial number of countries including India, was a landmark in boosting the pro-victim movement. Next comes the definition part. So the word victim is defined in section 2 clause WA of the CRPC, in which victim means a person who has suffered any loss or injury caused by reason of the act or omission for which the accused person has been charged, and the expression victim includes his or her guardian or legal heir. So next, you shall mention about the provisions governing victims of crime in India. So provisions are covered under section 357, 357A, B, 358, 359 and 250 of the CRPC. 357 deals with order to pay compensation, 357A deals with victim compensation scheme, 357B deals with compensation to be addition to fine under section 326A or section 376B of the IPC. 358 deals with compensation to persons groundlessly arrested. 359 deals with order to pay costs in non-cognizable cases, and section 250 deals with compensation for acquisition without reasonable cost. So next, you shall mention this very important section, which is section 357A. So let me read it to you, the brief of this section. So every state government in coordination with the central government shall prepare a scheme for providing funds for the purpose of compensation to the victim or his dependents who have suffered loss or injury as a result of the crime and who require rehabilitation. Whenever a recommendation is made by the court for compensation, the district legal services authority or the state legal services authority, as the case may be, shall decide the quantum of compensation to be awarded under the scheme referred to in subsection 1. So, a recommendation has to be made by the court. Next, in which cases compensation could be paid, like where the offender is not traced or identified but the victim is identified, and where no trial takes place, the victim or its dependents may make an application to the state or the district legal services authority for award of compensation. Fifth, on receipt of such recommendations or on the application under subsection 4, the state or the district legal services authority shall, after due inquiry, award adequate compensation by completing the inquiry within 2 months. Next, you shall mention about section 357A B. So it deals with the compensation payable by the state government under section 357A shall be in addition to the payment of fine to the victim under section 326A, 326AB, 376D, 376DA and 376DB of the Indian Penal Code. So let me tell you about the case laws which you shall mention in such type of cases. Lakshmi versus Union of India is a very famous case law. It's regarding rights relating to acid attack survivors. So in this judgment, the Supreme Court actually made regulations saying that while purchasing the acid, one should show their photo identity card given by the government and has to mention the purpose of buying it. And after the judgment, amendments were made in IPC, CRPC as well as in Evidence Act, where in section 326A, 326B relating to acid attack, it's against a crime relating to acid attack has been inserted. 357A and 357B was inserted in CRPC, which relates to victim compensation scheme, and 114B was inserted in Indian Evidence Act. So you shall also mention a brief about Central Victim Compensation Fund Scheme. So the central government in 2015 formulated the CVCF scheme to compensate the determined. So the first stage is making an application before the state or district legal services authority. So it has to be made by the victims or their dependents or the SHO of the area. Second comes the scrutiny stage, and third comes the disbursement stage, where a minimum amount of rupees 3 lakh is provided for both the victims of rape and acid attack. Next comes compensation under public law, wherein I have mentioned one famous case law, Bhajanpur versus Delhi administration. It's a case relating to payment of compensation to Sikh riots, which was done after the assassination of the then late Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. In this court, the Delhi High Court has held that if in any circumstances the state is not able to do so, not able to protect their life, liberty, dignity and worth of an individual, then it cannot escape the liability to pay compensation to the family of the persons killed during the riots.
And the High Court also directed the state government to pay a sum of rupees 2 lakhs with interest and also gave general direction that the order should apply to similar cases also. Then comes compensation under criminal law. In the very famous case law, Hari Kishan versus Sukhbir Singh, the Supreme Court highlighting the importance of Section 357 Clause 3 said that this power to award compensation is not ancillary to other sentences, but it is in addition thereto. It's a measure of responding appropriately to crime as well as reconciling the victim with the offender. Now comes the conclusion part. In modern criminology, the rights of victims have been enlarged by empowering the courts to award compensation suitable for their rehabilitation. This is a major achievement to the welfare of the victims, as the things were not same in the past. With the judicial intervention, the rights of the victims today are secured both under public law as well as criminal law. So these are the other questions. I haven't given you an elaborate answer, but I have given you the hint by which you can formulate your own answers. Like briefly explain and critically evaluate the VVPAT and EVM in the light of contemporary developments. So the case is Subramaniam Swamy versus Election Commission of India, 8th October 2013. What is meant by generic drugs? Explain its importance in the light of judicial decision. This in the case of Novartis versus Union of India and other, this is a 2013 judgment. In this case, what is generic drugs and its importance in India has been explained. Terrorism has become an international issue for long without finding any solution. Briefly explain and critically evaluate the same in the light of contemporary developments. So this case is actually relating to current affairs section. So I would recommend all of you to kindly refer the materials available on internet and formulate your own answer. So this is the end of the slide. I hope you like this video. Find us on social media, Facebook and Instagram. Let me know your doubts, queries, feedback, suggestions in the comment box below. I would reply you as soon as possible. So with this note, I am signing off. Have a great day.